Hello everyone, I am Jhalak Patel from Hazi Institute for Engineering and Technology in the Department of Electronics and Communication. Welcomes you to the session of Wireless Communication. Today, we are going to discuss about Unit 1, that is Introduction to Wireless Communication, with topic Third Generation Wireless Communication, Paging System and Bluetooth. So, let's start the session. In the previous session, we have seen about the generation of wireless communication, about the first generation wireless communication and second generation wireless communication. We have seen that first generation wireless communication, it is completely depend on the analog communication, while in the second generation communication, we have used the digital modulation technique, and in which we have further divided the second generation standard into the 2G standards, 2.5G standards, okay. So here for the basic 2G standards, we have seen the different standards of GSM. For the 2.5G, we have seen the HSPHD, that is your high speed circuit switch data network, and the GPRS, means general packet radio service. Now in this session, let's start with the third generation wireless communication. Here we can develop the enhanced data rate for this third generation. So we can say that it is the modified version of EDGE. So now let's start with the first applications of the third generation standard. So or which features it particularly provides compared to the second generation standard. So first one is, it allows the always on time of access. The next one is, it provides the voice activated call. Obviously, communication over VoIP, communication over voice over internet protocol, is possible with the third generation, with enhanced network capability as well as the different standards supported by the third generation is our vibrant CDMA, CDMA 2000 and TD-SCDMA, that is time division, synchronous, port division, multiple access. Now let's see first the WCDMA technique. WCDMA is basically the UMTS package standard. UMTS stands for Universal Mobile Telecommunication System. It provides the high capacity upgradation path of GSM, and it also provides the backward capability with the 2.5G standards. That is your, you can say that IS-95 and IS-95P. Always on type packet based system is it, and then the data rate that is provided by WCDMA is 2.048 Mbps per user, which is much more than the previous version of second generation standard. Also, it provides the public as well as the private data network. Spectrum efficiency always increases. If we increase the spectrum efficiency, then the better channel utilization is possible in this case. Next one is the CDMA 2000 standard. It is the original 2G standard. Its bandwidth is 1.25 MHz per channel. So 1.25 MHz per channel bandwidth is provided. CDMA 2000 will provide the radio transmission technology, means RTT. Here 1 cross RTT, 2 cross RTT and 3 cross RTT we can use. So here the watt change is generally desirable for this technique. Is about 1.25 MHz of channel is provided for this 1 cross RTT. If we say that 3 cross RTT, then 3 channels of 1.25 MHz is provided for that case. Also, it will provide the EVDO and EVDD standard. EVDO is evaluation of data only, and EVDD is evaluation for data plus voice. So this is all about the CDMA 2000 standard. Now for the next, that is TD-SCDMA. TD-SCDMA stands for time division, synchronous, port division, multiple access. So in this case, higher data rate implementation with the GSM base station is possible. The access technique that is used for TD-SCDMA is, as its name said, that time division, means time division multiple access, TDMA is used for it, and TDD duplexing technique is that. TDD duplexing means the transmitting and receiving is possible simultaneously but in terms of time slots. So this is about the TDD. Its bandwidth provider is 1.6 MHz of bandwidth is provided. Obviously, the time slots are there, so if we calculate the frame duration, it will be the 5 milliseconds in the 7 time slots. Also provides the dedication in providing the more forward link communication. So this is about the third generation wireless communication standard. Now let's start with the next wireless communication system, that is the paging system. And first of all, paging system. It is the first of all, page is a small message that is broadcast over the compact surface area. So system that small, that sends the small messages to the subscriber is called as the paging system. So here it is used to inform the subscriber that he needs to call on a specific number to travel at a known place. Here the role of public service telephone network is also important because it is at the end point for the distribution of the network is important. As I said that a page means a short message that is broadcast over a complete area. So now its range is in between the 2 to 3 kilometers. You can use this system. It also supports the simulcasting is possible. And next is it is one type of reliable communication system. Here for the paging system block diagram, first block for the paging system is PSTN. PSTN is distributed towards the paging control center. As you can see over here, there are the different landline link attached with the paging control system to distribute the network and to distribute the small message that is broadcast over network. So here the three landline link is used. One is the satellite link and it will be further given to the particular paging terminal that is located at the city. So here you can see that the base station is also there. Base station is your fixed station of the network. So this is all about the paging system, and from that paging terminal it will be given to the user. So this is how the user can use the paging system. Now what will be the pager versus cell phone? So this is one graph that will be the pagers versus cell phone graph. These are the number of advantages and limitations of the paging system. Like we can say that it is most reliable service, unlimited group call is possible. Also the long battery use is possible with this technology. While here you can say that the limitations are no group call is possible, frequency and no service during the emergency, and here it will be right when you need it for the congestion. So these are about the advantages and limitations of the pagers versus cell phone. It shown with this figure. Now the question is, why pagers transmitters are placed at a tall building? So for the simulcasting purpose as well as to get the maximum signal to noise ratio, it will be placed on a tall building. Also the small RF bandwidth is required. Small RF means more radio band frequency bandwidth is required for it. As well as for this, we can say that the low data rate, it offers an attenuation of 20 to 30 dB. We always try to minimize this attenuation level. And that's why these are the factors that we should keep in mind. And that's why we put the paging transmitter at a tall building. Next one is about the Bluetooth technology. It will be the short range wireless communication technology. It is one type of radio wave communication technology. It was first developed by 1944 by Ericsson platform. Five companies recently joined to form the Bluetooth Special Internet Group, and first specification was released in 1999. Range for Bluetooth is from 10 to 100 meter. Various features of Bluetooth is its connection type is FHSS. FHSS is frequency hopping spread spectrum connection type. Frequency of the spectrum is 2.4 GHz. Modulation technique used for this is GFSK modulation. With the data rate it supports is up to 1 Mbps. It supports the stations of 8 devices. Data security or authentication can be provided with the use of 128 bits. Module size is approximately 9 to 9 mm. Now for the connection type of Bluetooth, it will be the point-to-point type. Point-to-point, we can say that it will be the master-to-slave relationship can be shown as you can see over here, master to slave connection for the Bluetooth technology. And here this is point to multi point, here one master, and with that master the 8 number of slaves are connected. So this is one type of point to multi point. Let's see about the Bluetooth protocol stack. So it will be like this. Here for the RF layer, then the Bluetooth layer, in between them there is a protocol, and this stack will shows. We will see the detail about this Bluetooth protocol stack in unit number 6, that is recent trend with wireless communication. So we need to worry about this in that. So this is the graph that shows the core protocol, cable replacement, telephone control protocol, as well as the RF protocol. We can say that RF protocol is one type of air interface from the network. Baseband protocol is required for the connection establishment. LMP is your link setup between the device, it is required. SVT is your service recovery discovery protocol. WAP is wireless access protocol, and TPP is your point to point protocol. These are the several applications of Bluetooth, ease of use, end user experience, and the last one is mass production at low cost can be possible with the Bluetooth. This is all about the third generation standard paging system and Bluetooth technology. We will cover about the Bluetooth technology in detail in unit number 6 with recent trends. If you find any query or doubt regarding this session, you can ask me on my email ID. Thank you for watching.